and I have no other shelter than you. Therefore, please explain this to me. Purport. In this previous verse, it was stated that one can achieve the Lord's supreme abode by associating with the devotees. Therefore, Uddhava naturally inquires about the symptom of the distinguished devotees whose association can promote one to the kingdom of God. Srila Jiva Goswami notes that the personality of Godhead knows who is actually a sincere devotee because the Lord is always attached to his loving servitors. Similarly, pure devotee can expertly explain the proper method of devotional service to the Lord Krishna because they are already absorbed in love of Krishna. Uddhava herein requests Lord Krishna to describe the qualities of the devotee and ask the Lord to explain the devotional service that the devotees themselves approve as worthy to be offered to the Lord. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur remarks that the word Purushadhyaksha indicates that Lord Krishna is the supreme ruler of the universal controllers headed by Mahavishnu, and thus the Lord possesses the infinite sovereignty. The terms Lokadhyaksha indicates that the Lord Krishna is the ultimate supervising authority of all of the Vaikuntha planets, and therefore the Lord is unlimitedly glorious and perfect. Uddhava further addresses Lord Krishna as a Jagat Prabhu, because even in the illusory material world, the Lord exhibits his unlimited mercy by personally incarnating to uplift the conditioned soul. The word pranataya, your surrender to devotee, indicates that Uddhava is not proud like ordinary fools who do not enjoy bowing down to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. According to Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Uddhava mentions that he is anurattaya, or completely bound in love of Lord Krishna, because unlike others, great devotees such as Arjuna, who sometimes worship the demigods in order to comply with social customs or to show respect for their positions, the scheme of planetary management, Uddhava never worshipped any demigods. Therefore, Uddhava is prapannaya, or completely surrendered to Lord Krishna, having no other shelter. Om Ajnanam Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurum Militamena Tasmay Shri Gurve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Thapitam Ina Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Pada Kamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsa Shri Rupam Sagrajata Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamsa. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Kopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Yevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, राम राम हरि हरि हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरि हरि हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
Hare Krishna. It was very long purport, very nicely explained. Here Uddhava wanted to know who is the true devotee. This is what Uddhava wanted to know. What is the symptom of true devotee? Because here in the previous verse, it was stated that one can achieve the Lord's supreme abode by associating the devotees. By associating the pure devotees, person get achieve the supreme abode. So here he wanted to ask, what is that person who is a true devotee? So Srila Prabhupada, all the places he used to tell us in Krishna consciousness that one who takes birth in Bharat Varsha, they are all devotees. But Srila Prabhupada says, you have to become pure devotee. That is the difference. You have to become pure devotee. So, here even Uddhava is asking the same thing. These acharyas are asking just to give the benefit result for the people, audience. Real questions. Even question is asked by for Sukadeva Goswami, by Parikshit Maharaj, for all for a benediction of the people in Kali Yuga. Here I wanted to say something, because when we go for this devotional service, Maya is always attacking. This is very, very common. As soon as we think we are something, some level we have come, we have progressed in Krishna consciousness, immediately next moment that person will lose his entire energy. He may fall sick also. He cannot even do his sadhana properly. Maya is always attacking. So even at the time of Krishna's time also, the Maya was attacking. It is said today's world, there is a terrorism and suicide squad. And it is said even at the time of Krishna, there were suicide squads were there. You know who is that? Member of suicide squad? Putana. She came to kill, and she's put suicide squad. They are the team of Kamsa, King Kamsa, Tranavarta. These are all suicide squads. They are going to die, but they wanted to kill others. The suicide squad was there at the time of Lord Krishna was also. We say that was so good. There's a pure time, but even today, those things are there. Terrorism. Suicide squad. Even at that time, Shishupala, knowingly he was doing all those. And not only this, the Paundraka, he was telling, you are not the original Krishna. If today's case, that was the thing, it would have been a big, this media people have been a worldwide message. You are not the real Krishna, Paundraka used to say. I am the real Krishna. So that Sudarshana belongs to me. Send that Sudarshana to me. If you don't send it, I'll come for war. And he was ready with the soldiers. He went for the war to Dwarka. And he said, I am the original Krishna. Finally, Krishna said, you really want the Sudarshan? Take it. He sent it, Sudarshan went and cut off his head and came back. So these things were very common, even at the time of Lord Krishna. Now we think when we take spiritual life, immediately we think why it is happening. So many years we are chanting and still, why it is happening like that? Why so many thoughts are coming in our conscious all the time, many years we are doing. It is Kali Yuga, it is really, you know, our own mind is really speaking, they become a supporter for the terrorism. That's why one of our Narottam Das Thakur, in his wonderful narration, he said, Hari Hari Bifale Janama Gunainu Manusha Janama Paya Radha Krishna Nabajiya Janiya Suniya Vishakainu Janiya Suniya Vishakainu Hari Hari Bifale Janama Gunainu. So sweetly expressed, my Lord, I got a very rare human birth, you know, very rare. After many births, I got this. But taking this rare human birth, I have not taken the worship of Radha and Krishna, and knowingly I drank poison. Suicide, eh, na? What else is there? It's a suicide. Knowingly I drank poison. It's a suicide of the self. It's a suicide of the self. That's why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lord Krishna, he came as a devotee and he was just early morning asking everybody, Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago, Gaura Chandra Bole, Kota Nidra Jago Maya, Pishachi Rakho Le Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago. You have to make the Jiva to awaken the Jiva. He didn't say, Hey Ram, Udjao, Hey Krishna, Udjao, Hey Gopal, Udjao. Nothing. Jiva Jago. So, Srila Prabhupada used to explain it very sincerely and seriously, this Krishna conscious, very, very nicely. How to be a pure devotee, he has given very nicely. That, he said, you are not to change your occupation. Very, very clearly, Prabhupada was saying, you are not to change your occupation. Simply, your conscious has to be changed. And how can conscious be changed? Jnanagni dagda karmanam. Transferring the present self, interested, present self-interested conscious into Krishna consciousness. There is so many consciousness there. But that same present self-interested conscious to be Krishna conscious. Not to do any occupation, you are not to change. Very nicely he said. It requires knowledge. Prabhupada said it requires knowledge. What is knowledge? What is that knowledge? I am the part and parcel of Krishna. Number one. Number two, I am not different from Krishna. I am Krishna's. No difference. I am the superior energy of Krishna. I am the superior energy of Krishna. That is the spirit soul. That is the knowledge. So, Prabhupada says, you have to very clearly understand whatever the absolute truth is giving in Bhagavad Gita. One shloka he always quotes most of the places, that is, Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma Sashvatam Shantim Rachyati Kaunteya Pratijani Name Bhakta Pranashati. Prabhupada says this is Krishna consciousness. Never, when you take shelter of Krishna, you will never be destroyed. My devotee will never perish. Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma. Tatkshan, immediately you become Dharmatma. Even a Duratma becomes Dharmatma. Just having a connection with Krishna. Sashvatam Shantim Rachyati. permanent happiness will be available. Kaunteya prati jani name bhakta pranashat. Arjuna, go and declare, my devotee will never perish. That's why Prabhupada said, one who is taking shelter of Krishna, he will never be destroyed. Whatever Krishna speaks, that is an absolute truth. Absolute truth is always speaking absolute truth. You are part and parcel of that absolute truth. That is spirit soul. You have to do the connection. Huh? Where is the destruction? Destruction is when you lose the spiritual consciousness. That is the destruction. You'll consider yourself a material body or material activities. That is a destruction. And always you have to remember, you are the eternal spirit soul, Sat Chit Ananda, eternal, full of knowledge, full of bliss. This is always there. So Prabhupada's explanation is too good. You know the destruction in our material life, in real life, is our materialism. Materialism is the destruction. Which is not connected with Krishna, then it becomes materialism. We forget that thing. So my position is, Srila Prabhupada says, our position is like a football. Football is always kicked. Always kicked. Srila Prabhupada says, even our position is the same. Many lives, that kicking is there. That once they kick, we get the kick, we reach to China. Other kick, we go to Colombo. Next kick, we'll go to Pakistan. Next kick, we'll go to London or India. Just a kicking. We are like a football. The kicking is going on. This is Prabhupada's word. We have no place like football. So therefore, what we have to do? Krishna has come. He declares, just take my shelter. My dear child, there are lots of kicking is there. Anyone who takes shelter of Krishna, never be destroyed. Kaunteya prati jani namai bhakta pranashati. We hear it. I will take it, okay. There may be some other protection also. It's okay. Krishna said. But Prabhupada said, that is itself is absolute truth. That should be our realized knowledge. Krishna is going to take total responsibility. That's why Srila Prabhupada says to how to liberate yourself. And it's a very precarious condition. This we have to remember when you are chanting also, Prabhupada said. It's very precarious condition. The perishable body is having the imperishable soul. You have to get it purified within that short time, short duration. For that purpose you have come. That is a perfect Krishna consciousness. As Krishna conscious, many, many years we do chanting from so many years, 25 years, 30 years. Srila Prabhupada said gradually it should become a blossomed, fully blossomed Krishna consciousness. There is nothing else, anything darkness. Fully blossomed Krishna consciousness. After doing so many years experience of chanting Krishna's holy name. And by that, we will never back to the material world. Means no sense gratification. This is only this Acharya, Srila Prabhupada only highlighted this. Sense gratification means you will deviate from spiritual life. Sense gratification, you have not got the human form of life for sense gratification. You have come here for self-realization. Purify the soul. You have come for that. Remember this. No sense gratification. If anything is there, we are not fully, full-pledged way, we gave the food for the soul. If we give food for the soul, full-pledged way, the sense gratification, that seed will get burnt off. It will never come. Today's wonderful day of Gopal Bhatta Goswami's disappearance day. And all Goswamis, they had the associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Rupa and Sanatan, just Ramakeli, when they saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just having a darshan, totally they transformed from the material world. Rupa Goswami immediately got up, "I am leaving, my dear brother. Whatever is there, you take care." Immediately. This is the power of Lord's darshan. This is the power of Lord's holy name. Very important. Because Maya is some or the other attacking all the time. It is also agent of Krishna. How serious. Krishna said, I am going to protect you. That is 100% perfect. Prabhupada said, just go on that. Think on that point. And your soul, definitely you have to purify it. Whatever the anarthas are, be removed. Rupa Goswami is always says, Ado Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anartha Nivritti. Anartha you get Nivritti, it takes away. Then slowly you have to take Asakti, taste Ruchi, Bhava, finally Krishna Prema. It's a highest process. That process to be very sincerely we have to do it. Sincerity is highly counted. Even our Uddhava, he has been sent to Gopi's place, from Dwarka to, he has gone to Vrindavan, just to specify that Krishna is going to come. But as soon as he saw that Gopi's devotion, he totally transformed. They are in so high level. And I like to take my birth in Vrindavan as well, grass, as a root of grass, so that somebody may walk on this. I'll get purified. This is the really speaking, spiritual advancement we can understand by meeting such great souls, immediately the transformation takes place. Here the example is also given, Narad Muni. Wherever he goes, the transformation takes place. He has preached to so many people. Our Bhagavatam is of that. And plus, we wanted, Prabhupada says that you should have a full-fledged, full-blossomed Krishna consciousness. That should be there. Toda kil gaya, waisa full nahi chahiye. Full kila hua full. Krishna consciousness, full kila hua. There's nothing is less. That way it is needed. When you will get that? Food for the soul. You have to give proper food for the soul. Once the food is given to the soul, senses and our mind, they will also take part with Krishna consciousness. People avoid the soul and they try to enjoy the sense gratification, but that will lead us quite miserable condition because it's a bodily concept. Srila Prabhupada says even mind always it's got two habits, accepting, rejecting, accepting, rejecting. The beautiful car I want to buy with full efforts that will take, after a few days you know, material nature, car is going to be spoiled. He said, reject it. Bungalow, nice house, good area, Bombay. I buy, accept it, reject it. Same way this, in Grastha Ashram, selecting, boy selects the girl, girl selects the boy, accepting earlier, then reject. This is the constitutional position of the mind, accepting, rejecting. There also, you are going to be in difficult task because nothing is connected with the spirituality. And here, next third stage is giving food for the soul. Once you give food for the soul, what is the food for the soul? Harinam, Krishna's holy name. Take that. Because Krishna, Kali Kale Nama Rupe Krishna Avata. It's very easy to attain in Kali Yuga. He comes. One Krishna name can eradicate crores of sinful activities. Such a nectar is there. Today Baldev Prabhu was asking, what nectar you are going to give? I said, what nectar? Holy name itself is nectar. One holy name, one Krishna name can eradicate crores of sinful activities. That is a nectar. You have to all the time have full faith on that. This is going to protect. This faith, Srila Prabhupada. This faith, Prabhupada. Chant. And all whatever is unnecessary things will be out like. And one more wonderful thing Prabhupada is saying very, very nicely, that you are drowning here. It's like a Atlantic Ocean, Bhavasagar. You are drowning here. And this is not at all a comfortable position. People may think, I'm working very hard day and night, struggling day and night. But that is not a comfortable position. That is not your original position. It's an ocean of material existence. And in necessity, summer must take us out from the ocean. Somebody should take us out from the ocean. For that sake, Krishna speaks in Bhagavad Gita, Tesham aham samudarta mrutya samsara sagara. Krishna says, I promise you. The word is so beautiful. I promise you. I take those who are in Krishna conscious out from this ocean of birth and death. Out from this ocean of birth and death. Janma karma chame divyam. Umeyemitti tattvata. Tektva deham punar janma. Naiti mamiti swarjana. I'll take you out from this. This bhavaroga. Bhavasagar. It's a huge thing. It's Atlantic. When we'll realize that fully blossomed Krishna consciousness, Prabhupada says, 24 hours, Krishna is monitoring you, and that realization you should have. 24 hours. Even we are sleeping, as we very well know, it's a common factor, as everybody knows. Krishna consciousness is so cheap. People think, Krishna consciousness. But it is a very high level of upliftment from human form of life. To peak with Krishna, as soon as you take Krishna's consciousness, you are gone highest peak. Which is the peak here? Himalaya. Which is the highest peak? Himalaya, from there, Mount Everest. Prabhupada says, taking Krishna consciousness means Mount Everest. You are going to Mount Everest, uplift, topmost, and enough. Then your life is perfect. This you have to do it. This absolute truth we should remember. And one wonderful explanation is, example is given by one, His Holiness Gaur Govind Maharaj. I wanted to express that. How the soul has to be, we have to feed the soul properly. Food for the soul. Very nicely he was explaining. That there was a very strong bull. And that bull was very, very much hungry. It was searching for some of the grass somewhere. So one fine garden was there. But that garden was fenced. Strong fence was there, iron fence. This bull could not tolerate its hunger, so it just goes and, bounce with that and it's cut open, just gives such a kick for that, and with all those efforts, all those strength, it break opens that the fence which is made out of this, that's a strong fence, but it opens it, break opens it, enters inside. And enters inside and goes there and has that grass nicely. After that, slowly comes and takes a rest. You know what is the example? Our hungers for Krishna consciousness should be like that. Never to care for any of the fence of this world, any of the terrorism, any of these obstructions. Where is Krishna Katha is going on? Let me go there. So he was referring, even people from London, people from Russia, people from all over the places, they used to come running here to hear Krishna Katha, to India, Vrindavan, just to hear Krishna Katha and take the feeding. That hungry soul wanted the food. So it used to come, nobody, it was not bothering, like that bull was broke open that fence. That enthusiasm they come. Even they are having hand to mouth only, they are not the very rich people. Because they have to feed the soul. You have to feed the soul properly. Once you feed the soul, all your senses, all your enjoyment, propensity, it decreases 100%. Because otherwise, we are leading to ignoring the soul. If we wanted to enjoy, we are leading to very miserable life. Feed the soul. Give Krishna consciousness nicely. Then you will get that. You'll be in the higher level of Krishna consciousness, fully blossomed Krishna consciousness by chanting the holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Actually, who is the, even in our scripture and Acharya's proof only we can understand what is the way to deal with it. It requires a fully Krishna conscious. Prabhupada said it is the highest necessary to become Krishna conscious. It's not an option. You have something other option. No, it's main job. Full main job. You can't be many people used to say I'm very dharmic. I have not done any harm to others. I am morally living. I am truthful. Is it not enough, Prabhupada? Swamiji, is it not enough? Swamiji said, to remain as dharmic, remain your quality as a truthful person, you have got a good quality, but to keep this quality maintained properly, you have to take shelter of Krishna. Otherwise, Maya will attack you one day. You cannot avoid that. It's independently, you cannot avoid it. That's one example is there. See, example of, especially Prabhupada says this, quotes this, Mahatma Gandhi. He has done lots of job for India. Lots of job. He fought for independence, and Satyagraha, lots of things. The result is the Satyagraha is going on now also. Because original founder Acharya he was of Satyagraha. But he did so much job, but finally what happened? It was all bodily concept. There was some misunderstanding at last. There was a dividing of nations. He was shot dead by the people. If we do 99 best job. If we do one wrong, people will reject you immediately. They will never consider this person has done 99% perfect. He did 1%. They will never excuse you. This is the power of Kali Yuga. Even children's, even relatives, they'll fight for it. And difference is, you did 99 wrong. One goodness if you do, Krishna will uplift you. This is the difference. This is the difference between material world and spiritual world. So sweet. At least you got one quality, my child. Come. You were an illusion. Don't worry. I'll protect you. This is what example we got it from Jagai Madai. They had all full bad quality. But Nityananda Prabhu's mercy was such. Don't worry. Even the Jagai Mada hit him also. But he said, don't worry. Whatever the pious activities are there, those pious fruitful thing. I will award you. You become a Krishna conscious being. Say, ek bar Krishna bolo, Hare Krishna bolo. See the compassionate thing. This is what we can see from these acharyas. It is all connected to Krishna conscious being. And two things immediately we'll get it. One is jnana, how to live, how to connect ourselves to Krishna's. And second thing is vairagya, renunciation, vishaya vairagya. If we have least, we cannot do japa properly. That least never ends only. So if our least is ended, we can say your progress in Krishna consciousness. 25 years, 30 years, I don't have any least. My least is only that when the time will come, I should be ready with all my quota of Mahamantra. These sages were asking at Janak Maharaj and all, when they were meeting, they were asking, you know, what is that? How is your family? Not that. Punarjanma Jaikar ho gaya aapka? You could arrange that? There's so much capacity of spiritual balance you have. Any call comes, are you ready with that Mahamantra? If you are not ready, don't waste time. Chant more and more rounds and accumulate in your account so that you'll get NOC for going back home, back to Godhead. NOC to be produced. The NOC itself is holy name, because the holy name is Divya. Holy name is everything. And we are part and parcel of that. We are Krishna's. We are not this body. Highest illusion, Prabhupada says, of course, I don't want to speak the higher philosophy. Highest illusion is that this bodily concept is going to destroy you. This body, within this body, the soul is there. Uplift that. Give food for the soul. Wherever possible, walking on the street, walking on the subway, traveling on train, flight, car, at home, anywhere, just Krishna name should come. That is your accumulated eternal spiritual wealth. Mahamantra. In Kuru Purandara Dasa's thing, Usuru Usuru ye kusumanabhanesar. You should come to that level, every swasochwasa, every breathing, that should be a Krishna's name. The capital will go straight away. This is how acharyas have said. You should have, otherwise we will be attacked. What is this? Today's terrorism. And that terrorism is within us only. As Narottam Das Thakur has said, I drank poison. I was knowing. But my mind took me here and there, senses took me there and postponed it. Yeah, Krishna consciousness is very good. If you speak with anyone, they said, bahut achha hai, karo. Lekin aaj hum mera kaam karo pehle. Kal se shuru karo. It's postponing. No. Just whatever the time is there. And one more thing I wanted to say. One more thing. Krishna is monitoring everything 24 hours. It's very simple. Lub dub, lub dub, lub dub is going on here. We are not set right the thing any day, giving some key or putting some cell or something like that. That lub dub is going on. Supreme Lord and our spirit soul both are working within. When they vacate it, Ram Nam Satya finished. So from the womb onwards, the thing lub dub is going on. And plus breathing, pranavayu. Nicely we are taking it. They both are monitoring there. 72,000 now system, they are monitoring everything. And Krishna is monitoring totally. And this realization we should have, Krishna is there all the time with us. He is monitoring everything. He is monitoring our all activities. External, internal, all activities. So, once we understand this, we will never deviate from Krishna consciousness, because we never offend anyone. We will never offend anyone. No deviation. Once you get deviate, finished. Because you think, nobody is there. No, let us speak something about somebody. Gramya katha. No. He's 24 hours he's watching. If I wanted to speak anything bad about Madan Gopal Prabhu, immediately I should think Krishna is watching. He'll say he won't feel better. Good. I am offending, Krishna is watching. He will remark. Remark will be there in computer automatically, because nowadays, even in while you are driving, you have to be very cautious. They have put all the cameras. Even the policeman is not there. He will go in red light. Immediately it will come, a call will come. There is fine on your account, so much, 300 rupees. It is on your account. You pay that. Otherwise it will accumulate with interest. So when Krishna is there all the time watching us, how can you offend others? Why we don't go for other unnecessary thing? We don't eat onion, garlic, we don't go this, that. Why? Not for anything else. Krishna, to please the Lord. Samsiddhir Haritoshanam. Dharmam tu sakshat Bhagavat Pranitam. This instruction is given by Lord. This is the perfect system. I should be disciplined. So once you start with that chanting, good round of chanting, then immediately this propensity gets cuts off. Krishna is watching 24 hours. That is the example of Kanakadas. You all know the story. In Udipi, Vyastirtha, their guru gives one banana to everyone. Go and have this. It is a common story. Everybody knows. Have it in such a place, lonely place. Nobody should see it when you are having this banana. So everybody goes. Kanakadas was hearing. He was the outcast patient, outcast student. He was hearing from out. He also takes it. Then they come on the next day. They said, Guru was asking, you had all this banana? Yes, yes. Somebody said, I covered it, a big cloth and had it. I went inside the dark room, I had it. Some said, I went inside the water well and I had it. Some said, I went to a big mountain, I had it. Good explanation. Very good. They were very happy. Ramacharya, Bhimacharya, all Veda Pandits. And Kanakadas brought it back. And said, why? Kanaka, why you didn't take it? Guruji, you said there should be, you should be lonely, nobody should see it. Every nature was saying, sky was saying, and all these woods were saying, the trees were saying. Finally, Krishna was everywhere, Lord was everywhere. I could not find any place as such. He said, you are the perfect student. You understood what is dharma. You understood what is spiritual. I am very proud of you, Kanak. So this is exactly that thing. This is one of the example. And finally, what is Krishna conscious? Pure Krishna conscious. For him, anya abhilashita shunyam. If there is abhilasha, you will have least. There is no abhilasha. You have to test. That is our parameter. Our least is got over or still it is there. If still the least is there, you cannot prepare for going back home, back to God. You have to come back again. There is no least. Your only least is that when the time will come, I am ready, Lord. Because that is my house. Allide nammane, our house is there. Purandaradas says, illidu summane. In Kannada, His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj's biography is given a name, Alli Denammane. Our house is there. This is Summane, this is Futayal. Here is the Dharmashala, you have come to purify yourself. So Alli Denammane, you have to go there. When you are going to your own house, you'll never be sad, na? When we are going, Gaon mein koi jata hai, bahut din saal ka baad, Mumbai se, bahut kush ho jata hai. Nothing is there in Gaon, but still you feel very happy, theek hai. Toda hi paisa hai, chalega, mera Gaon. Jao Devacha Gaava. That is the place. And you have to make everything very clear. It's a clear cut is given here. And that's why even Haridas Thakur, finally. Haridas Thakur wanted to give up his body before Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, how can you leave Haridas? How can you leave me? He says, when you leave, what would be my fate? How can you leave me? So Haridas was saying, my Lord, I am like a mosquito. If one mosquito dies, what difference is there? And it's not that in an exaggeration position he wanted to be show that this lowest position. No, they meant that. They meant that. It's not just abhinaya, actor, you know, becoming is it transformed, totally transformed. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this mercy was, these all the people were requesting for the king, Pratapudra. Even he was requesting, please, see that I should meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu one day. They all tried. He said, no, he is Vishai. I don't want to speak to him. Finally, by seeing his nature, he's, even though he's a king, he's very humble. He was really with a big broom, he was cleaning the road of Jagannath Rath Yatra and so many other reasons. Finally, he found, and at last, Sarvam Bhattacharya says, Krishna is, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to give you the mercy. Please, be ready. And it was at Rath Yatra day, and in some of the place, there's in middle, there's one garden, is there, Vallab garden. He goes and takes rest. That time he sends him, please go now. You change your dress. Like that, we have to change our dress. We have to change our material dress just to take the mercy of Krishna. So he becomes just like a sadhu. Sadhu's dress, he goes there. And before going, he takes all the Vaishnava's blessing. Krishna Prema, you will get it. With very great efforts, very, very great difficulty, he went there and started massaging his feet. And massaging, he was singing Gopi Geet. Tavaka Tamritam, Tapta Jeevanam. And what happens? When the time comes there, Burida, Burida. Who is that? So lovingly. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gets up. From where you got it? Who are you? Who are you? Burida, who are you? Then Raja says, Raja kahe ami tumar dasara nudasa, brityara brityara yehi mora bilasha. Raja says, I am your servant of the servant of the servant. And life after life, I have the same intention. Lord, immediately, Lord gives him Krishna Prema with very happily, with tears. Dasara nudasa. This is very difficult job. Das das anudas. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave us. You see, I know something. I am a very expert speaker. My English is very good. I am an engineer. I am a solicitor. These are all things okay. No. You have to become the servant of the servant of the servant. And how? These all Goswamis, we can get the quality of Trinadapi Sunishchena, Tarorapi Saishnuna, Amanina, Manadena, Kirtaniya Sadar. With that, Gopal Bhatta Goswami met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he had been to South India Yatra. Venkata Bhatta's son, the child saw him, immediately attracted. And he said, after doing all the service of your parents, you come. I will accept you. And because of his wonderful, pure devotional service, Gopal Bhatta Goswami's, he got Radharaman manifested by Saligram. Even today, their worship standard is too wonderful, high class, top class worship. Like Madhvacharya's system is too top class, even today. So this is because of that same quality they had. They got the blessing from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All these Goswamis. So this is the asset for us to learn and see. These all Goswamis are standing on the altar. It is just to see, oh, wonderful, nice. We have to pray on this wonderful day that, Lord, my dear Goswamis, see that I should be worthwhile person in this material world to taking your shelter. At least I can get some drop of your consciousness, that is full-fledged Krishna consciousness. No any type of intoxication or no other type of, you know, contamination. I wanted that. Today we have to pray that. That's why here, knowingly, what is the quality of a devotee? Even Uddhava asked that question. So today, the main thing is that we have to pray for that. In this material world, it is very difficult to fulfill the promise. For that purpose, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu alone had come. Because of the request of Advaita Acharya and other people. So alone had come, and as the very genuine Acharya, he gave us absolute truth in a form of mantra aushadhi. This aushadhi can be used for any place at any samskara. That is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. I am a bit over time. Hare Rama.